As you can see in where I'm standing, this entire area looked like it was burnt. Probably someone was preparing land for cultivation or maybe construction. Unfortunately, fire spread very fast and it almost brought down the power infrastructure that you're seeing right behind me.
The northern region continues to grapple with man-made power outages. In the last 2 weeks, approximately 21 power poles have been burnt by uncontrolled fires.
Boroboro 11 kV serves part of the town, and then the structure at the extreme end is Kampala Road stroke Ngeta 11 kV. It also serves about 60% of the load in Lira town.
Bush burning is a common practice in the northern and western region, especially during the dry season. Villagers claim that burning is part of their hunting practice, such as clearing their hunting ground for rats and mudfish. Others burn for cultivation.
To allow the animal to come out so that they can hunt it. Others, when they are drunk, when they are having a matchbox, they just burn the bushes. That is due to pressure from the alcohol.
The dangerous practice has come to the attention of the local leaders. They decry the practice due to its socio-economic consequence.
It is very serious. And this is where we are calling for our brother in Umeme to really pull up power outages. Actually, it affects people who are manufacturing. Those who are baking bread at night, those who are, they really cry foul.
Vandalism is another challenge, and the most common target are the stray wires and fire fabrics.
This power pole is burnt, and as you can see, it is about to fall anytime soon, and if it falls down, then definitely the Kitbull region will not be having electricity. Do you know why this happened? It's because the fire fabric, which is normally tied around this place, was removed by the community. And from what we've been told, they use them in their houses, some of them as carpets, while others for hosting guests.
This technology, it is being used in Namibia, because Namibia is also victim to forest, to bushfires. It's being used in Namibia to limit the effects of bush burning.
Umeme officials, in partnership with the local leaders, are currently involved in a sensitization drive whose objective is to curb the burning practice and vandalism.
Throughout the districts of Lango, Lira inclusive therefore, all sub-counties have bush burning policy and bush burning bylaws. And once you are caught, you are really apprehended, because bush burning can even destroy many homesteads.
Despite the presence of bylaws aimed at combating bush burning along the power lines, their implementation is not effective. Dennis Sigoa for UBC News.